Now for some videos, examples of what to do if you want to write the equation, okay? So, let's say that we want to write the find polar form. Let's say it's of a parabola. I'll tell you that one. Parabola. The focus is at 0, 0. Again, we talked about that. We're going to always be at the focus is 0, 0. And the directrix is y equals negative 9 fourths. Okay. So let's find the polar form of this parabola. Okay, for ourselves. Okay. So it says parabola. So the eccentricity is 1. Okay. So we know that. Okay. We also know the distance from the focus to the directrix is 9 quarters. Okay. So if we go to look at our equation here, right, we know the top, e times d, is going to be 9 fourths. Okay. We know there's going to be a 1 here. We just have to figure out, is it plus or minus, and is it sine or cosine? So we take a look at this. Okay, hold on a sec. Okay, sorry for that pause. I had to go admonish the puppy for stealing the big dog's food, because that's what he does. So, okay, we're back. So the directrix is down below, and it's opening up. Okay, so if we think back to what we had there, if we have a horizontal directrix, that means that this distance, right, is vertical. So that's a sine, right, for ourselves. So we're definitely gonna have the sine of theta. So that's how I remember it's sine. Okay, and since it's below, right, it's going to be taking away from that distance. I'm gonna have a minus there, right? Right, that if it's here, it's taking out from the distance, so it's a minus. And so I just need my e right here, which is 1. I could write that or not, but I have that equation. Yes, it's a compound fraction, so I'll multiply top and bottom by 4. So that's not a compound fraction. And I get the equation of, that's it. It's all set, right? You're all, okay. Could you convert this to rectangular form? Absolutely, you could convert it to rectangular form at this point, right? If we look at it, we can figure out, you know, we can find this value right here. Well, we know that's going to be the halfway point, right? So if that's 9 fourths, right, from the given information, then that's 98. Make sure I got that right. 9 fourths, right? So half of that's 9 eighths, right? So that's going to be so we can get that vertex for ourselves. We can and plug that in. We also know that the distance we're going to have, the p value we're going to have, is this right here. It's 9 eighths, right? So you're going to be all set, and you're going to plug it right in and be able to get those points, right? Get the equation you need. Okay. If we had an example that was a different conic, unless they just say it didn't tell us what the conic was, okay. So let's say that this conic had a focus of 0, 0, and it has a directrix, x equals 6, okay. It says the eccentricity is 2 thirds, okay. All right, and let's just find the polar equation. Okay, so eccentricity of 2 thirds. Okay, so now it's an ellipse that we're dealing for ourselves. So if we have to sketch this, that's going to help us there. Okay, we also know that the d equals 6, the distance from the focus. Okay, one of the things that we were assuming here, and the problem needs to do a very good job of telling us, is that the directrix that goes along with this focus, it could be for the other focus. In theory, that would be a much harder problem. Probably not going to deal with that this year. No guarantees, but probably not. Right? But we're going to make the assumption that that's for that focus. If it's not, then it's going to be a different equation. Okay. So if we're thinking about our equation here, if we think about, let me graph it first. X equals 6 is over here. Okay. So second. Okay. Yep. All right, so we're going to be going this direction. Okay, so that's going to tell us that we're going to have ED. This is to the right, so it's going to be if we're looking at it. Make sure I have this right. Not the correct equation. Okay. Yep. It's going to be 1 plus E cosine theta. It's on the right there. Okay, for ourselves. And so then we have E and D, right? So if we multiply those two together, what are we going to get? We're going to get 4 for our numerator, right? Get 4 for our numerator. Okay. Eccentricity is 2/3, right? Cosine theta. Well, you can see, right, for that one, well, I mean, that's a pretty quick one for ourselves. We multiply by 3. And we have our equation there for it. Okay, if we want to graph it, then we do use the same techniques we did, for example, 1 and 2 to sketch those graphs for ourselves. Okay, let me just flip through my examples real quick, make sure there's nothing else jumping out at me that's like, wait, don't forget to do that before we leave. No, I think we got it all. Okay, so good luck with those problems, and look forward to seeing you during our office hours on Tuesday and or Friday.